What's up, guys? Call the Truth here with some more Battlefield 3, and today I've got a round of Rush Attack on Operation Metro. I'll be running a couple of kits here. I think I've got the UMP-45 in the Assault kit, and then I'll change the M4-17 in the Recon kit. But this gameplay is not important at all, just backgrounds. Actually, the competition in this gameplay was not too good. I think the good players really had left because this was at the end of a night after playing for a while. So we're playing against mainly a bunch of rookies, but you know, we figured why not stick around for one more match till we leave. But I have gotten my no gun glitch problem fixed that many of you guys know about. Now, this gameplay is actually pre-recorded from then. It's probably about a week and a half ago, I think, maybe 2 weeks ago that I recorded this. So this is before I really ran into the glitch problem. But finally, I did get it fixed, and you may be wondering how I fixed it. Now, I could have, you know, bought a disk drive or bought a disk cleaner and really torn my PlayStation 3 apart and gone through it and tried to replace it that way. But I love playing with you guys so much, and I really enjoy putting out videos of you all, getting some, you know, some new stuff, great games I just got. So I have a YouTube channel, and I really do enjoy playing with you guys a lot. So I said, forget it. I'm not going to put up with this PlayStation 3 that's I don't even know how many years old. It's an 80 gigabyte. This thing's pretty old. I think it came out, was it the third one it came out, or maybe the second? I know the 40 gigabyte came out around the same time, and oh, I just got no-scoped. Woo! So this thing is pretty old, and I figured I am not going to put up with problems with this anymore. It's no longer under warranty. I don't want to have to fuss with thing myself when other parts of it begin to break, so I said, just screw it, and I bought a new PlayStation 3. I bought a brand new 160 gigabyte PlayStation 3. They weren't as expensive as I thought they would be, but you know, it still was kind of expensive. But I did buy an extra warranty for that thing, so it will be should be good until the PlayStation 4 comes out, which I know that's going to come out sometime. I mean, it's going to come out in the next couple of years, so this should be covered until then. Hopefully be covered till then. I couldn't imagine PlayStation 4 wait as long as it takes for this warranty to wear out, but I have gotten this problem fixed, and I wasn't really sure how to do it, like start out with. I wasn't, you know, should I have to save it to an external hard drive, kind of like an extra media device or something like that. But it turns out that the PlayStation 3 actually has a data sync transfer, basically. You stick an Ethernet cord, and you can hook up the two PlayStations together and just transfer the data. So that was rather convenient to have that. And okay, that's really all about it for the gun glitch. So if you just want to hear me talk about that, that's it. The only other thing I want to comment is this weird, like, laggy, glitchy shot thing I do. People are like, what is that? That looks so dumb. It's ridiculous looking. And it is. It's so stupid looking. In Medal of Honor 2010, I did this with my pistol a lot. And it really helped me get kills. Believe it or not, it actually helped me get kills. I learned it from a guy who I no longer play with anymore or really am associated with. But it actually worked, and I was having some fun with these guys. I'm like, why not just try it in Battlefield? You know, I did it in Medal of Honor 2010. Why not just try it? And it worked. I mean, I got myself some kills. I was rather shocked. But, yeah, it was kind of funny just doing that and getting surprised by getting quite a few kills for it. So I know it's kind of funny. You could try it if you want in Battlefield. I wouldn't recommend it, though. It's really inaccurate to shoot your weapon with. And Medal of Honor 2010, though, go for it. It's a lot of fun to use. So now, what I might do with my old PlayStation 3 is actually make a video maybe of me tearing it apart. I can go through it with you guys, and especially for those of you that have the same model. I know most of the videos out there, a lot for the 60 gigabyte ones. I might do one of the 80 gigabyte. That way, those other people that maybe run the same problem as me and don't want to buy a whole other PlayStation and just want to replace the disk drive, I may be able to do that for you guys. So, hope you all enjoyed the video and the commentary today, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.